Next time, I'll rip your fucking legs off and shove them up your ass till you've toes for teeth. Gear up in the nick of time, as always.
Zoltan, with your boot to someone's ass, as always. Who were those men?
Local color. I wasn't going more than a moment. Long enough for them to turn our home into theirs. All right, time for some spring cleaning. I've got to boot them all out. Care to join me?
With pleasure.
Walking into his soul!
Now give me back!
Another chappy. We're leaving.
Die, fool!
Reminds me of a piece of war.
Yeah, almost like we never left Bergen.
Told you to ask. Told you to know.
I'm pleased. That went well. Now we can greet each other like the gods ordained. Ages past.
Hey, Zoltan. You look good.
Training plenty lately. What with the war on, no Mahakaman meat to be found, but Redanian lagers standing in just fine. You, though, you've withered a bit. Something worrying you?
It's about Ciri. I know she came to Novigrad. Might still be here.
You mean she's come back? I'll be damned. I wonder if I'd recognize her. How many years is it now? 6, 7? But what'd she be doing here?
Hiding, probably. She might be in danger.
See her in your dreams?
Couple times. Her and the Wild Hunt.
Oh, not good.
Not at all, but I know she came here and contacted Dandelion.
We have a wee problem, then.
Where's Dandelion?
I'd like to know that myself. Maybe he can explain what the hell's going on. I just barely returned, as you saw. Expecting to come home to a hot leg of boar and some cold ale. And what do you find instead? A shite storm. Dandelion gone. The tavern chocked full of bums. I've no clue what happened.
Let's look around. Might find something that'll put us on his trail.
Prime idea. I say we start on the ground floor. It's where he sat and wrote.
From the finest vineyards, every last one.
No one knows the... Aha! A note from a grateful muse.
Reading someone else's letters.
My visage red.
From the finest vineyards, every last one.
No one knows the fruit of the vine like Dandelion.
Annual balladry contest. Silver laurel awarded to Master Dandelion.
Prince Hereward himself did the honors. And the feast afterwards, to celebrate the laureates. Dandelion taught a swine to yodel, and I... Ugh, another time.
Hmm. 10 barrels of Toussaint Dry, 5 cases of sodden triple mead. Nothing here.
No! That's exactly what we're looking for! It's his planner!
Huh. Dandelion and planning? Good one. Besides, anything he wrote here probably had a special system. Chaos only he could ever decipher. Actually, in the past, sometimes not even that.
Give him a chance. Might not be that bad. Seems when he inherited this fine establishment, it came with some fine responsibilities. Bookkeeping among them. He also made a habit of noting down the times of his meetings, official and private. So, who'd he been seeing of late? Ah, here it is. Seems he's only been meeting women of late, the dog.
Not a bad idea. Dandelion's pretty loose-lipped. Might have blabbed something to a lady friend that'll put us on his trail.
That's what I'm counting on.
We should divide these somehow. Perhaps... Ah, fuck it.
I'll ask the lassies in my half, you interrogate the ones in yours. Suche?
Zoltan, wait. This is in verse.
And you figure that's unnatural because...
Wonderful. Meet me back here when you're done. Share our findings.
Right, yeah. Need to do a wee bit of tidying before I go. Cannot stomach the idea of coming back to this mess. And you'd be wise to read your bit before you scurry off. If you need anything, I'll be next door.
Yeah. Another drifter in from Tamir.
Julia, are you agreed?
I will get you every last copper. With interest. Give me a week, please.
Horson's no banker. He's an honest man. You pay on time, you get protection. You don't pay.
Help!
What you hollering for, stupid wench? What are you hoping for? A knight in shining armor?
Close enough.
Keep out of this, Greyhead, not your concern.
Vespula's got someone else's protection now.
Really? Who's that be?
The King of Beggars made a deal with Junior. This is his turf now.
Didn't hear nothing about that.
But you have heard what Bedlam does to people who cross him. Or you need a demonstration.
Come on, Fritz. Boss wants it that way. It's how it's gotta be.
Thank you. Oh, thank you. To think there are men who'll help a stranger out of the kindness of their hearts.
Not entirely out of kindness. And you're not entirely a stranger.
What are you... Oh, I know you. You're that witcher took Dandelion out whoring. Gerald, right?
Not Gerald. Geralt.
Oh. Dreadful sorry.
What do you think? Where could Dandelion be?
Probably out whoring. That horse pheasant. That lying scoundrel.
Ouch. What did he do to get your goat?
Same thing as ever. Prize bullshitter came back, saying it was till death do we part this time. And no more than a week passed before I spotted him in Harborside, strolling with some trollop on his arm. 'Twas the last straw. All those questions about the washerwomen at the bathhouse, then this. I beat him black and blue and threw him out on his ear.
This woman he was with in the harbour, who was she?
Claimed she was his niece from Covir. Ha! Horvir, more likely. Corset so tight her eyes were popping out her head. His too, come to think of it. An artist or a whore, doesn't much matter as they're one in the same.
Thanks for your help. Listen, when I find Dandelion, anything I should tell him?
No. I mean, tell him he's a two-faced snake, but it would be nice if he dropped by.
Friend of Dandelion's, looking for Elial.
You've come to the right spot. How might I be of service? Need something shortened? Patch your trousers, darn your socks.
You, Eliel?
Yes? Now pick your jaw up off the floor.
Sorry, I thought... thought Eliel was one of Dandelion's girlfriends.
Ah, so it's that. Wait here. Any better?
So you're...
Eliel.
Did you and Dandelion... I mean... how did you two meet?
I met him one night in a tavern. He was blind drunk.
What happened?
What do you think? We spoke.
That's it.
I'm not sure what you're getting at, but I should make one thing clear. Men don't interest me. Told him that as well. Luckily, Dandelion's an open-minded fellow. We had a lovely evening. He became a loyal customer afterwards.
Dandelion visit your shop often?
I tried many times to talk him into a decent doublet. Sadly, he'd only come in to get a button reaffixed or a hole patched.
When did you last see him?
Some time ago. He brought in one of Zoltan's jerkins, insisted I sew on an extra pocket. Odd as requests go, I had the distinct feeling he'd actually come to talk.
Thanks for your help, and nice to meet you.
I can help with much more. If you need new trousers or a vest, you know where to find me.
Excuse me. I'm looking for Marabella.
I am she. Wait outside. Class is in session.
I'll wait.
It won't take long. What do you want?
I know you saw Dandelion recently.
Oh, yes. Longest afternoon of my life.
He read you his poems?
No. He perused the illustrated guide to fungi.
Maybe... won't even try to guess why he wanted to do that.
Mold. That was his interest. When his hand abandoned my knee to point at a figure of penicillium, I knew the fire between us had died. Permanently.
See Dandelion after the fungus incident?
No. I even considered granting him another chance. His heart of hearts is pure gold. He simply needs a bit more discipline in his life. But he never came back to see me. So I thought if it's done, it's done.
Thanks for your help.
Are you a horse in the
tree? Arms for bread, please, for folk.
Nay, not like that.
What difference would it make?
Set with silver studs.
Ah,
no. I'll have it for you next week. I was here last week, and you also told me to come next week.
Exactly.
This Baroness Lavalette's villa.
Shouldn't interest you. The Baroness don't mingle with just anyone.
Don't worry. I'm here to see your chambermaid, Molly.
Out of the way. Baroness is right now. Be gone.
Geralt of Rivia at my doorstep? Surely this is no chance encounter.
Greetings, Baroness. Greetings, General. You're right. I'm here for a reason.
There's no mistaking you. But for etiquette's sake, Mary Louisa Lavalette, an Imperial General and a Witcher meet. And know each other. Surprising.
Yeah, we had an opportunity to, talk when the Emperor summoned me to Vizima.
Had you run afoul of Var Emrys? No. You'd be long dead if that were so. It seems, then, that you share some interests. But I shan't question you out of doors. Will you accept my invitation? Tell me what brings you here.
Looking for a girl named Molly. Heard she works here.
My maidservant. I'm afraid she's currently at the home of my dear friend Patricia Vagelbud.
Perhaps Geralt could accompany us. He could speak with Molly at the races.
Is that something you'd consider, Witcher? Care to partake of some sophisticated diversion?
Think I can find my own way to the Vagelbud home.
Very well. Perhaps I can convince you to join me later at the races. I shall keep an eye out for you.
Just this morning, my Greta came back from the market with news. Some mysterious murders happening in some house.
Your Greta's for the imagination of a crime.
Intolerance and superstition.
I'll chase the pain all the way to the guards.
Did you catch him?
What do you want?
Want to see Rosa Varatra?
Oh, mate, if you only knew what I want. Miss Rosa don't see just anybody.
I'm Geralt of Rivia, a Witcher.
Soon as Miss Rosa turns into a Striga, I'm sure her papa will send for you. But she's not showing any symptoms yet, so I'll venture you're not needed. On your way now.
We meet again, Witcher.
Yeah, managed to get here. Truth be told, hard to miss an estate this grand.
My father owned a similar estate in Bruges. As a young girl, I'd travel there often to ride.
Shall we look at the horses? Do you like horses, Geralt?
I guess so. Called every horse I've had Roach.
The grey mare is Cantarella, sired by Cahir, the champion from Vol.
Grey's a nice color. For horses, too.
My coin's on the black stallion, Nemrod, purest Nilfgaardian stock.
Surprised it didn't salute you, General. Seem to know your horses.
No is not the word. Morvran's a true expert.
I find them to be far more honest than men. Must say, I'm curious how you manage in the saddle, Witcher.
Mostly just try to stay in it.
What would you say to a little race?
Not what I came here for.
Don't make me beg, Witcher. Tell you what, win, and I shall give you my finest saddle, made in Nilfgaard proper of beautifully tanned leather.
Why not? Wouldn't mind seeing if your knowledge of horses translates into riding skills.
Well said. So, which steed do you choose, Witcher?
The gray mare looks nimble. Besides, knew a man named Cahir once. I'll go with her.
I'll not ride with you, but I shall bet on a steed. Nemrod will win, no matter the rider.
In that case, I shall try my luck on the Zeracanian Bay. I see no point in delaying this. Let's begin.
Riders, ready!
Come on, Witcher!
Let's go!
Go, go!
rush of air! Come on, Witcher! Let's see what you're made of!
What a thrill! A beautiful victory!
Thanks.
For one for whom every horse is a roach, you carry yourself exquisitely in the saddle. My congratulations. That is yours.
Now, could I talk to your chambermaid, m'lady?
Ah, yes, Molly. That is why you came here, after all. The portly young woman. That's her.
Speak to her. And you must find us when you're ready to return to Novigrad. We'd be delighted to join you for the journey.
Nothing hurts as much as life.
I'm Molly, milord. Wish to see me?
Call me Geralt.
Geralt? That Geralt? The one Dandelion's rescued time and time again?
That's right. Except it's the other way around. I'm always saving him.
Mean to say it weren't Dandelion saved you in Flotsam by severing your noose with an arrow from 100 paces?
What? Dandelion couldn't... Never mind. Any idea where our master archer might be at the moment?
No. Sadly, I haven't got a clue. We've not seen each other in ages. The Baroness don't approve of our acquaintance. Says Dandelion's a good-for-nothing layabout. Can you imagine? But... or maybe his sister could help you. Such a nice girl.
You do realize Dandelion doesn't have a sister?
Sure he does. Saw him himself. Funny, she don't look like him at all. Blonde, for starters. Maybe they've different fathers.
Mm-hmm. Different mothers, too.
Maybe. But you could see he cares for her. Looks after her. The way he carried her packages and...
Know where I can find her, Dandelion's sister?
I know. Whenever I asked Dandelion when we'd visit her, he'd grow all quiet and then change the subject.
Any chance you remember your last conversation with Dandelion?
Of course. He came to borrow some coin for a barge.
What? Why'd he need a barge?
To take me on a romantic cruise of the canals by the light of the moon. Said there'd be strawberries and that wine with the bubbles, and he'd sing me arias. But I've not seen him since.
Thanks, Molly.
Wait, before you go, I've got a request. Dandelion told me once he'd show me his etchings, but he never did. I'd so like to see him.
Won't be too hard to convince him. He loves showing off those etchings to anyone he can.
Oh, that's wonderful! Thanks, and good luck to you on your search.
Geralt, there you are. Shall we return together?
Gladly. It's a long way to Novigrad. Road ought to seem shorter with some company.
I'd say the same. Well then, let's go. And here we are. Thank you for your company.
Likewise. See ya.
Who are you? Why are you here? Answer this instant or I'll summon the guards.
Sorry to sneak in, miss. I'm Geralt, a friend of the bard Dandelion.
Geralt of Rivia? The famed Witcher of the Ballads?
What are you doing here, vagrant? How'd you get in? I let no one in the front, my lady. I swear it on the great sun.
Not a word. I'll handle this. Hold your tongue, sir. This is Frederick Francis de Bergerac, my new swordplay instructor, correct? Show him to the training room. I shall join him shortly.
But my lady's a witcher. Said so himself, back by the gates.
Captain, do you truly believe Rosa Varartra would train with random clods calling themselves swordmasters? No. The Varartras demand the very best. Thus, we've hired a witcher. Take him to the training room, now.
As you say, miss. Won't you realize what you've got yourself into?
Hope so, too.
Miss Rose has got a downright beastly temper. Shows no mercy once she grips a sword. Grab a wooden one. And take care not to hurt the little miss. Follow me.
You're my new instructor. Well, well, Papa clearly went out of his way this time. Wood, to start with. I must know your worth.
Imagining things? Didn't we just have this conversation in the garden?
The garden? Yes, yes, in the garden. So, what was it you said? Why are you here?
Came to ask about your rhetoric tutor, Dandelion.
Rhetoric tutor? Good one. That is why Papa hired him, but not at all what the bard had in mind. He mostly played his lute and sang for us. I believe he thought he was wooing.
Mean he wasn't? But you had some sort of relationship.
If you call him chasing after me a relationship. Even so, there was nothing between us. Seems my sisters had a bit of fun at our expense. But enough chatter. Stand and fight. I demand a rematch.
Given me no choice.
When you can barely handle one.
Time to end this.
Damn it! Well, if you're not an instructor, you should certainly be one. Fancy giving me a few private lessons?
outrightly refuse a request from a lady?
What are you two lovebirds whispering about? You asked about my relationship with Dandelion? Well, here's the mix-up's mastermind, Edna Va'atra, the greatest mischief-maker north or south of the Yoruga.
Hang on. So it was you in the garden?
Of course it was me. Why, did Rosa try to play you for a fool? Don't be mad. We've done this since we were children. People have always mistaken us for one another.
Take it, Dandelion did too.
On occasion, yes. But then Rosa would quickly set him straight. If you'd shut your catty mouth for a moment, dear little sister, I could explain. Edna sent Dandelion some love letters. She signed my name. Conceited as he is, naturally he fell for it. I was left to repel the aging bard's advances. Rosa, I had the best of intentions, you know that. I felt you needed help taking the first step. You blushed every time he sang a ballad. He'll next sing at your funeral if you don't stop it right now.
Calm down, ladies. No poet's worth two sisters nipping at each other's throats.
Especially not this one.
Listen, I just want to know one thing. Either of you seen Dandelion lately?
Edna might have. I certainly have not. My dear sister, I would never spend time alone with a man for whom you burn with a secret passion. Burn with passion? For one who incessantly praises another woman's talents? Afraid I've more sense than that.
Who'd Dandelion sing about? Know anything about her?
I believe she's a poetess, or trabaritz. Very skilled and exceptionally talented, of course.
This woman, not a local, right?
I seem to remember him praising her melodious Kaviri accent. Makes sense. He referred to her as Kalonetta a few times. Bizarre names are common in Kavir.
Gotta ask Zoltan about this Kalonetta. Been a pleasure, but I've got stuff to take care of.
Exceedingly nice to meet you. Please come again. Well, can I expect any more lessons in future?
Awfully convincing, miss. Wonder where you learned it. Name the time and place.
House here, tomorrow. Same time as today.
See you then.
See you, Master Witcher.
You're back! You met Poppy? Sure to stop talking any day now.
Zoltan, venture to say a mage would have trouble turning that owl into a parrot.
Sure you know me that well. Mark my words, she'll be playing Quint with us in no time. But we were to talk about Dandelion. So, how'd you do? Learn much?
Women on my list hadn't seen Dandelion in a while. All claimed he had been acting strange. Also mentioned he'd been seeing someone else. Thing is, mystery woman wasn't on my list.
What's she supposedly like, this lass?
Blonde, from Kovir. A trobaritz, apparently, named Kalonetta or something like that.
That makes it clear as crystal. It's Priscilla. Aye. Must be her.
Who's this Priscilla?
A trobaritz, like you said. Quite popular of late. Picture Dandelion with a pair of tits, and you've got the general idea.
Interesting image. So how'd Dandelion handle meeting his female double?
I think he fell in love.
What can I say? Could be he finally met his match.
She's his match, all right. Maybe more? The laddie's head's on fire. Lassie's got him whirling.
All right. Guess we gotta talk to her.
Priscilla works with a mummer's troupe, Reynard and the Foxen. Whenever they're in town, she performs nightly at the Kingfisher.
Mean we've been sentenced to an evening of poetry?
Must you always? This'll be true poetry, Geralt. You'll see.
Ugh. times.
Oh, what village are you from?
Oh, yeah.
We lies.
Like dung that flows to the sewers, so the worst scum flows into Novigrad.
Lay me there with a barrel of beer and a cup. Here's my right hand. Here already. Come on, let's find some arse rests. Should start soon.
'Twas him murdered some Temerian boys back at White Orchard.
Silence, woman. We've come to hear music.
A murderer?
There's a war on. Some die.
Oh, please, argue this out elsewhere.
Squabbles and rows again. And I was told this was a decent establishment.
If I know Geralt, he risked his noggin to save someone else's arse.
Save, you say? He murdered folk.
Don't let him provoke you.
There's the door. Settle this outside.
Come. I wish to listen to music. Music!
Cultural capital of the world? The fuck it is.
Permit me to introduce this here's Priscilla, known also as Calanetta. As lovely as she is talented. And this
is Geralt of Rivia, I know. Dandelion's told me a great deal about you, and I've listened with bated breath. Don't be surprised. After all, doubt I could think of a more fitting subject for a ballad than a witch's love for a sorceress. Or should I say, sorceresses.
Seems Dandelion was meticulous in telling my story, down to personal and insignificant details. Did he offer anything about himself, like where he was going?
Splendid. Very funny, truly. So, see you later.
Not here. Come with me.
There a reason for all this sneaking around?
An excellent one. When last I saw Dandelion, he told me he was planning a heist. Siggy Reuven's vault?
Sheeped up.
And I've not seen him since.
Let me guess. Attempted heist was a failure.
Well, he's not driven up in a gilded carriage laden with jewels, so I should think so. I've asked after him everywhere. But it seems an army of tongue-stealing cats has overrun the city. I learned only that he raised a ruckus at Horson Jr.'s lair. Then Horson's men chased him all over town.
Horson Jr. doesn't ring a bell.
Biggest prick in Novigrad. Not literally, but...
Got it. You're not a fan. But what did he do to you?
Try the whole town. He's one of four bosses who control the city's underworld. The others being Siggy Reuven, Carlo the Cleaver Varess, and the King of Beggars.
The rascal. At least he didn't cross the church as well. Bring that venerable institution into it. I'd be in deep then.
Here I go again, rushing to Dandelion's rescue. He ought to pay me a salary.
Wherever he is, I sincerely doubt he's in the mood for jokes. Nor am I, in fact.
Relax, I'll get him out of this. Gotta talk to this Horson first. And Siggy Reuven. Know where I might find them?
I don't know about Horson, but Reuven runs a bathhouse. Careful, though. He's a dangerous character.
So am I.
I don't doubt it. The Dandelion's not. I beg you to hurry. Let me know as soon as you learn anything.